Welcome to the TI Precision Labs presentation on how to select the right switch for UART applications. In this video, we'll review UART and discuss when to use a multiplexer, the parameters of interest when finding the right signal switch for UART applications, and common places where a multiplexer is used for UART communication. We will start with a high-level overview of UART. UART stands for Universal Asynchronous Receiver Transmitter. This is a push-pull architecture type, which eliminates the need for pull-up resistors on the lines. As the name implies, UART is a device that receives and transmits data via configurable packets using configurable asynchronous clocks. This means there is not a shared clock signal to synchronize the output of the bits from the transmitting UART to the input of the receiving device. Instead, these devices use individual transmit and receive wires for serial communication that relies on an agreed-upon configurable specified frequency. Typical applications use a pair of transmit and receive lines to communicate between two UARTs. Four-wire communication can also be implemented using a request-to-read wire and a clear-to-send wire for flow control. However, this isn't as common. Unlike communication protocols such as SPI or I2C, where multiple devices can be incorporated on the same bus, UART communication is peer-to-peer, meaning that there is no real primary or secondary device. Rather, typical UART applications consist of two interlinked devices that can send and receive information between each other. Therefore, to accommodate a system that may require multiple devices to communicate with a single primary device, a multiplexer can be used. Next, we will look into how to select the proper multiplexer for UART applications. When looking for a multiplexer that can handle switching between UART devices, it is important to consider the specifications of the communication protocol and layout between the UART devices. UART data is transmitted serially in one of three modes: simplex, where data is transmitted unidirectionally and independently; half duplex, where a signal is transmitted bidirectionally, but individually; and full duplex, where data is transmitted bidirectionally and simultaneously. While these modes are important for proper communication between devices, TI switches are bidirectional, so operation under any mode is possible with any signal switch. When choosing the right signal switch, the important specifications are the data transfer rate, whether two-wire or four-wire communication will be implemented, and the number of primary and secondary UART devices that will be communicating to each other. In addition, the on-capacitance of the signal switch should be taken into consideration. The agreed-upon frequency with which the UARTs will transmit data is called the baud. Since this is a binary serial protocol, the baud will equal the bit rate. Typically, this value ranges from 9,600 baud to 256,000 baud, or bits per second. When searching for a switch or multiplexer that can work in your application, this will also be the frequency used to calculate the bandwidth. It is recommended to pick a switch with the bandwidth at least 1.5 times your data rate. For example, let's take a transmission rate of 115,600 baud. This translates to 115,600 bits per second, which equates to 1 bit or 1 cycle per second. A signal switch with frequency bandwidth of at least 1.5 times this rate to ensure reliability is recommended. This will equate to a signal switch with a bandwidth of at least 174 kHz. Next, it is important to take into consideration whether two-wire or four-wire interface is being used and the number of UART devices to be switched between. Typically, UART only uses two wires for communication. This means that in most cases, a two-channel signal switch will be sufficient. The number of switches to be switched between will determine the needed configuration of the switch. For example, if a single two-wire UART is to be switched between two different UARTs, then a two-channel, 2-to-1 single pull double throw switch will be the best for this application. As another example, if one UART is to communicate to four devices, a two-channel 4-to-1 MUX will be the best fit. Finally, since UART communication is digital, it is important to note the on-capacitance of the signal switch. Because UART applications are peer-to-peer, Introducing a signal switch adds capacitance to the line that typically wouldn't be seen. It is important to minimize this capacitance as it will directly impact the bandwidth of the signal and the RC time constant. This in turn will affect the rising and falling edges of the digital communication signal. The quick search bar on the switch selection guide can be easily implemented to help narrow the search for the right signal switch for your UART application. Simply filter the configuration and channel count that best fits your needs. Next, select a power supply that will encompass the voltage range of your signal. Typical UART applications see voltage levels anywhere between ground up to 3.3 volts or 5 volts. The signal switch's power supply will typically be a good indication of the maximum recommended signal level that can pass through the switch. But it's always recommended to check the datasheet to confirm the recommended signal path input-output voltage range. After you run the search, make sure to select the on-capacitance filter on the list of filters on the left. The results can now be filtered and sorted by bandwidth or on-capacitance. Here you can select the switch that meets your needs. Thank you for watching the TI Precision Labs video on how to select the right switch for UART applications. To find more switches and multiplexers, technical resources, and search products, visit ti.com/switches.